So, this is the second match between Ciroid and Tomatello. With me is Andrew. Hello, Andrew.
Hello, everybody.
And we're going to see the follow-up between the long and exciting game between Weyland and Criminal. This time it's a slightly different matchup of Anarch and Weyland. So let's see how this resolves. Hopefully it will take less than 1.5 hour this time.
I'm pretty sure that noise will make things go faster.
Absolutely. Either he burns himself out or he snatches everything from R&D in a few turns. Oh, very nice start for Anarch. Medium on the first hand, plus Wildside and Aesop, so he can quickly trust if he needs to. But also a really good start for Wayland as well. Melange protected by an ice wall.
Yeah, it's gonna be interesting.
Going to be really, really powerful from Wayland, I think. Let's see how it goes. And he actually mulliganed. I'm guessing he has different cards he wants to have in his hand. Maybe the economy, like there. And the imp is going to be brutal, as always.
Yeah, I actually run Imp with my criminal deck. Only one because I can't afford the influence, but a very good card.
Yeah, it's such a nasty card when you get to play it. But I guess now with a criminal deck, it might make more sense to run the new virus. The one that
The
lets you
one that
look.
reveals more nerve agent.
Yeah. Less influence cost and still makes your runs worth it. Don't you think?
Yeah, it's probably a good splash, but yeah, sometimes it doesn't help all that much to see that many cards from HQ. So it's Imp is definitely more powerful because you can just always trash. You see a card that you see Adrian's Wall or a Toll Booth, you can just trash it. That one will just let you see that that's there. It reveals more information, but it's not a golden card. It can backfire. You can access two snares at the same time, or two fatal AIs, or stuff like that.
Yeah, but usually either the corporation cannot pay two snares at the same time, or don't know. But now the corporation is going to pay a bit for not protecting his headquarters. He went straight for the money, but it's going to be brutal now that an imp is going to trash. If he's going to hit that archer, ouch.
Yeah, we'll have to see. He might want to go for economy first, which is not a good move.
No. Maybe, if he plays one card, plays his economy, and then the imp and runs, then yeah. Then it makes sense because he can still play the card.
Yeah, no, he's just going economy.
He's
Like
just
I
going
said,
full economy, yeah.
I don't know why he bothered. I think he's using the milling deck, so he doesn't care that much about runs on actual HQ. He's just going to install viruses
Yeah,
and
but
either
on
fast
the other
escape.
hand, he's going to play that Melange. So next turn, the runner is going to go Grimoire, Imp, Run. So
Yeah, that is true.
it's still going to hurt. At least he would be foolish not to do that.
I'm pretty sure that's his plan, so
There we
pretty safe,
go.
yeah.
And time to pay the piper. And that's a free trash as well. I wonder if he's going to use the imp. Probably shouldn't.
Might as well, it has three counters anyway.
No, because he wants to. If he ran again now and hit something else, he'd be able to trash that. So if he
Yeah,
ran.
but I think he's just gonna go for the money. Or, I don't know, we'll see.
It's only two credits, man. I'm not sure it's worth. I don't think it's worth it. Also, I see a source scorched earth now. Ouch. But I don't think he has it. Oh, the other guy has archive memories.
A very good card to have with noise.
As I said, the problem is that with him you have a limited window of opportunity. You want to exploit it as much as possible. So it would be much better to trash that card manually and then run again with the imp. So you can trash two cards out of headquarters.
Yeah, but it depends on whether he was actually planning for the second run, and he wasn't. He just wanted one short run, and that was it.
Okay, that's going to be nasty now because he cannot get into any server, and that Melanz is going to just keep on giving.
Yeah, it's a pretty powerful start from Waylon.
Let's see if he's liking pulls a Yogg. A Yogg at the moment will be disastrous for the corporation. Or a Corroder would also be very good.
The mimic would be the most painful.
He would allow him to get R&D and archive, so yeah, you're right. But I think it would be much more worth it to hit headquarters at this point than to hit R&D. I don't know. Oh, perfect. That is so perfect now. But he's playing it safe.
Yeah, I think he's gonna use a milling strategy pretty much. He's gonna try to thrash as much as he can, and he's gonna run more than.
Yeah. Straight for the
He's
money.
probably hoping for a parasite or something, and that would just let him go through that ice wall and thrash the melange.
Personally, I would just go straight for the money, then run R&D, make sure that he exposes those eyes, and then because you know, if you find the sentry, you find the hole that you can exploit.
Yeah, definitely. That's what you want to find early game. Find something that you can run and just run that as much as you can.
That Melanz has given so much money now. If I was a corp now, I would be thinking seriously of wiping that imp. No, he
Yeah,
just.
probably a good idea.
He's going for the economic advantage. And the economy of the runner is amazingly good.
Best economy anarchs can ever get.
Oh, there goes an extra click. See, this law, I mean, if he had run those Caduceus, he would probably have been running R&D quite a lot now. He would have played another Enigma now, but he only pulled it now.
Yeah, but I think he might be considering running it next turn.
Probably will. Would you play your Mimic before you actually run this case? I mean, you haven't seen any sentries, so there must be one somewhere. And there's Well, and is famous for playing with good sentries like a Shadow.
Yeah, there's no risk in running it because you're pretty. The only risk would be splashing an Ichi.
Yeah, but now it can be an Archer.
And now it's gonna be an Archer. And he might actually think that that's a good bluff. It's good that he played that because it's gonna make him think that that might be an Archer.
Probably now he's going to use the Parasite to get through the Melange. There we go. Make sure
Yeah,
that.
definitely a good idea. Yeah.
It's a bit too late though. I mean, the corporation already has a truckload of money.
Yeah, but you still want to do it. You don't want to leave that up to all.
Obviously not. Obviously not. But three turns of Melange, it's so much, so good.
Especially for Wayland that can make a lot of money anyway.
People don't know this, but you can actually trust the eyes of the opponent. So you don't have to wait for them. You can just target it and press delete. And that will trust their eyes. And he's also trusting it for free because of the bad publicity, yeah?
Yeah, that was at least a good move. Yeah, he's gonna probably short gamble or something.
Makes sense.
Or maybe run. Running's not a bad idea right now.
Yeah, running. Get that Caduceus out, make sure that you can that you know what you're running to next turn. No, you're going for the money.
Even if he runs into like an archer, yeah, he loses an imp. That's bad, but he knows he has deja vu and
The problem is that he needs to be playing his cards, otherwise they go to waste because of the wild side.
The wild side, yeah. But he does have good economy, so.
Yes, but it's, you can never have too good economy. As you can see, that the player has 27 credits.
Yeah, he's not going to be able to outrun the Wayland.
Guess we're going to see the first remote server building. Here comes the archer. Yeah, it's a pity he didn't hit that archer with the imp. It would have been really big.
All yeah, that would have been great.
Every other ice he doesn't care about, but the archer, oh we.
Yeah, archer against Anarch is just brutal.
Well, with a parasite you can take care of it, but yeah, it still takes quite a while, and you still get the hit once.
Yeah, it's one of the worst for them.
Bad choice. Don't put two cheap sentries against Aragorn. What's the point? He should have put his Enigma on the R&D. Now he put two cheap sentries on the R&D, which means that that his Mimic can break
both.
Yeah,
I'm pretty sure he put it for the scare tactic there, and he's not really going for it. He might just thrash it later on. And
yeah.
he didn't want the shadow on the remote. He wants like ice that actually stops.
Yeah, true.
The run. Yes, but now the sinking is on the other side.
Still think it's better to play that mimic and then run, because I guess Wayland, you know, they have these sentries that give them money. You want to break them before they get the money back.
Yeah, but he probably doesn't want to use that deja vu to get his mimic back.
Why would he get his mimic back if he has an archer, you mean?
Yeah, exactly. He's afraid of running into an archer. Did we lose the connection?
No. Why?
No, nothing was happening and I was wondering.
He's activated his shadow, do you see that?
Yes.
Okay. Yeah, now he eluded the trace. Now he's going to see the two cheap sentries and he's going to go like, perfect.
Yeah, he's going to be all grin. And
yep.
That imp is just going to wreak some havoc.
Yeah, he's not going to do it now. He's,
as it should.
He's probably...
No, that's the problem, because the corp doesn't have any more ice.
Yeah, so now the corp is a bit naked. One thing I always keep in mind with against playing Arca, you need to keep an ice in the hand. Because against parasites and against stuff like that, if they trash your important ice suddenly, you need to be able to replace it immediately. Otherwise you have a problem. So let's see how much he's going to try and spend to stop him from seeing the next card. He has the money. I really need to make the trace results also display. I thought I did, but apparently not.
It will also be really good if when you pay for the trace, you can see the base value of the trace.
You do see the base value of the trace. Ah, you mean when you do the trace? Well,
yeah, when you do it.
Maybe I should put it in the window. I expect people to know their cards. I was going to make him pay 6. And he's not going to pay.
I always forget if TMI is 2 or 3, or if restructured data pool is 2 or 3. So that's what screws me over.
So now is the perfect time to go mimic run.
Oh yeah, that's exactly what he's going to do. No doubt.
And the best thing if he sees an ice that can stop the run, you're like, oh, trust. Oh, you know you want to do it. Don't even think
yeah,
about
he can
it.
Really do some damage now. He can definitely do some damage.
And it cost him only 4-3 to break with a bad publicity. It's like, oh, yeah, so good. No!
And in the end, he did spend some money from the corp.
Maybe he's afraid of a snare. I can't explain it.
Yeah, that's what I think. He's afraid of a snare. He'll just install the mimic next turn.
Yeah. And Tomatello is just going to go through and find his agendas.
Yeah, that chum on R&D doesn't do him any good.
That does, though. He puts a chum in front and then boosts his shadow twice.
And yeah, but it doesn't do anything. It's still breakable with Mimic.
No, it's not. If the charm is not broken, then it means that Sado is at strength 5.
Oh, Shadow's gonna be a strength 3. It's strength 1 to begin with.
Yeah, and then he boosted twice with he boosted twice with advance.
Yeah, with advancements, yes. Yeah, he needs
there we
to
go.
Advance it now.
He needs to advance
it to advance it at least once. And that's yeah.
I would probably do it 2 times just to make sure that data sucker doesn't get through.
Yeah, or a nice carver.
Or a nice carver, exactly. I don't think he's going to do it this turn, though.
He doesn't have the money. To do it twice, at least.
Tomatello, you mean? Yeah, because he drew.
Yeah, sorry, not the money, the clicks, yeah.
Let's see if he's going to go straight. I think he really needs to start running a bit. That R&D is ripe for the taking.
Yeah, and he knows it. But the problem is, yeah, that new ice really brings something new to the equation. Yeah. He probably won't care much about that one.
The problem is, he shouldn't be afraid of an archer at the moment. He has just one imp to lose, and he has another imp in his hand. He can take a face full of archer without really an issue.
Yeah, but right now I think he really wanted to do the mimic and run.
Yeah, but he doesn't. That's the thing I'm wondering. He doesn't actually do it. I think he keeps getting good cards in his hand. He's too ashamed to let them go to waste.
Yeah, if you play Anarchs, you need to take a bit of risk.
Yeah.
Anyway, so just go for it. He has the second imp in his hand. He's safe. We'll see what he does. Oh yeah, there he goes.
He goes naked though. Personally, I would have let him through. It would still have given me a lot of money, and it would have just let him see a card at best, but most likely
yeah,
not because
he's not going to pass that Caduceus anyway. Not
yeah,
cheap,
exactly, yeah. Exactly. So why give out your tricks?
Yeah, he gave out extra information for next to nothing. Yeah, I'm thinking that he will. If that shadow doesn't get advanced, he might just mimic next turn. Hopefully, he really should.
He really should do something. He's playing far too conservatively again. Again, in regards to all the other runners we have seen.
Yeah, there's another archer. Which is just great because he does have two cheap agenda.
About to score, yeah. I wonder if he'll play it on R&D now.
Like you said, I think he should just keep it in his hand, not actually play it right now.
And it's funny how we see all the good stuff he could have been trusting. He could have trusted that chum. If he ran last turn with a mimic, he could have trusted this archer if he ran this turn with a mimic.
Yeah, that's the luck of the draw. Yeah, it just happens. Yeah, it would have been a good idea to run a bit more aggressively, but he does look like he's trying to build his economy up because yeah, another liberated accounts. So he's going for the big money.
Problem is, Wayland builds better than you do.
Yeah, I don't know exactly why he keeps building. I think he might try like a virus rush to install a lot of viruses and trash a lot of stuff.
Maybe, maybe. Another good thing would be possibly parasite on Enigma, force the corporation to defend our headquarters. Waste one ice there.
Yeah, Parasite has a lot of good potential targets right now.
Yeah, see where
The
that
worst
is going.
pick, the worst pick would be on the shadow, because if you put it on the shadow, then that chum will just super boost the Caduceus, which is not what you want.
Now, really, the runner needs to start running aggressively R&D, because if those archers get res, you're not getting through that, and you're not going to have a big trouble stealing any agenda from that server. What? Why is he targeting?
I have no idea, probably a misclick. Two djinns, they come in pairs.
Come on. Time to do some damage. Play that mimic.
Yeah, that mimic just cries to be installed. It's like, put me down.
Yeah, man. Help me help you.
I want to do some damage.
Basically, the best play I think at this point is Cyber Feeder, Mimic Run. And then you run for free pretty much. And you don't
Yeah,
waste any card.
exactly. He just runs for free. He doesn't even need the cyber. I would not cyber feeder.
No,
I would just.
he saves me him the money, so why not?
Yeah, but I'd like to see more cards, actually.
Yeah, maybe. But I think he just wants to trust stuff instead of just seeing them. Oh,
Oh
come
man,
on. You play
come
far
on.
too. No, don't play that imp. Don't play that imp.
We're gonna, yeah. If we don't see it
No.
cleanse, if we don't see it clean, that's a misplay.
Yeah,
Five
absolutely.
counters of imp.
Don't. You don't do that. You just
Why?
don't.
Why did he? Why did he even bother drawing? Just cleanse them all.
Well, let's see. Let's see how it goes. Let's see how it goes.
It's not bad because he can score it. He will score this agenda. He can overscore it. It's an Atlas, so he can get his last. He can just go for like the priority requisition after this and go for the quick win.
Unless
But
now I think the runner is going to start finally with the imp. Let's see with the R&D.
yeah, he needs to mimic now.
He can do two runs and trash two cards, so it's not bad. Let's see. I think that's his plan, but it was very risky. If the corporation wiped, he would have been like, ugh.
Yeah, and the corporation should have fought.
Yeah, absolutely. Five. I wipe with two counters usually. Five counters, that's a god gift to Earth.
Yeah,
Honest.
he's probably very confident that he can just win with his Atlas and go from there.
If he doesn't run, I'm going to cry.
If he doesn't run, we have no idea what he's waiting for. Absolutely no idea.
Problem is, he doesn't have the money to run twice now.
Yes, he does, because he runs for free.
He runs for free. He runs for free for once, but then he has to pay.
Oh, that's true.
Oh, he has two bad publicity, so yeah, it's a bit easier now.
And he did have a liberate the concert.
Oh, he did use a liberated account. I thought he ran without it. Okay.
Yeah, no, he's just gonna run once.
I think he may have been able to run twice, but we'll see.
don't know, because he installed a mimic, he did...
Yeah. No, because, look, you let the Shadow take the 2 credits, and then you just...
Oh, yeah, definitely. He could have run twice.
Yeah, absolutely. I think it was a mistake there.
Yeah, I would have run twice, too.
And now he's advancing the Shadow, so you can't... You have to take the tax now.
No, advancing the Atlas.
All right.
Yeah, I'd give it one more advance.
Okay, interesting. He didn't defend R&D.
He wants more tokens on the Atlas. That's what's happening.
Okay. Well, now is the perfect time to run maybe three times.
He has so much money and he can just do it.
Just do it. He needs how many agendas to win? He needs 5. He had 4 last turn, last game.
Yeah, exactly.
So if he just blitzes R&D, he has to hit something.
Yeah, but Tomatello won last time, so if he scores 3 more points, he just won.
All right, yeah.
And if he scores that Project Atlas, it's a draw. Mm. At least.
No. Tomatello won last time, and... Clearwood had 4 points. So if Tomatello scores that Project Atlas, they tie, correct?
Yeah, the only problem is he will use some of those hostile takeovers for archers anyway, so...
Mm.
Oh boy! Why does he bother? Oh, okay. That makes some sense.
Mm. Still, it's only one run, and he's going to wipe afterwards.
If he doesn't do it now, I don't imagine when he'll do it.
Yeah, but he's going to see 2 cards and going to wipe both, so it's not a bad idea.
Yeah, it will work.
So, he's going to be left with 1 imp with 2 counters. Actually, he did a mistake last day. He should have used the other imp. Because he can only use 1 imp per turn, so...
Yeah, he didn't really care right now. Yeah, I did notice a priority acquisition crept up in Tomatello's hand.
Yeah, I saw it myself too. Just saved that agenda in the last moment.
Yeah, he can basically just win the game.
Yeah.
Score that and saw the other one advance it twice and wait.
Yeah. 1 point! He's 1 point. Yeah. Why did he discard? Ah, from his. Yeah. He didn't even have to use imps. Okay. So let's see if he's going to do that. I think that's the best play. That server is so secure.
Yeah, the problem is if he just lets him run, he's going to see a lot of cards. Yep.
No, but...
We're going to see an archer come down on R&D.
You think so? I don't think he can win.
Yeah. That mimic and those imps let you see so many cards a turn that he's going to put out.
He should really just wipe, honestly. It's better than playing an archer.
Might not be. Because with that, I think you're right. I think he should have just wiped. But it's too late now.
Yeah. Surprised there was no agendas yet in the archives last time I checked.
Yeah, I just checked now. I was just looking at it and there's nothing there.
Hmm. A lot of sinking.
Yeah. Did the other people that were supposed to be playing now contact you? Because they should have started now.
I haven't checked because it will affect the recording. If you want to take a look, if there's anybody waiting for a game.
Yeah, I'll have a look. Are they Malvolio with Kufal?
Yeah.
Yeah, they're on.
Okay. If you want to tell them that we are recording another match, so they can start their own game if they want.
Okay. I'll send a message to Malvolio right now.
Actually, maybe we'll finish soon. Tell them if they can wait like 10 minutes.
Sure,
think,
I'll do that now.
yeah, maybe this game will end soon.
Yeah, I sent him a message and I'm waiting for the reply.
Okay. So something interesting happened while you were gone. He trusted everything on the headquarters and played the archer, which I'm not sure why. He could just have trust the shadow and then Caduceus would be at 5 strength.
I have no idea why
That was
then.
a bad play. Now he basically let him run for very free. Let's see what he sees. This might actually give him quite a lot of agenda points. That's 3 cards to access. Let's see what goodies we have.
One agenda, two
All the single
agenda.
pointers. Whoa! Wow!
That is one good run. One hell of a run.
Oh no, that's 1 point to win the game! Wow!
Yeah, that's super strong.
Imagine having won the game like this, yeah. He would have been pulling his hair, the poor guy.
So strong. The only problem is I don't think this game will end that soon now.
No, I think
When
it
those
will.
archers pop up.
I think it will. I think Tomatello is just going to play the agenda and score it. Try to score it. I don't think he has the points to do it.
Yeah, but if he scores it, if he scores that one, and the runner runs on the remote server, then we're gonna see some archers.
Yeah, true. And that means he won't have enough points.
Exactly.
But if you do see some archers, it's going to mean that he's going to trust his whole rig. So.
Yeah. Plus, we can just stop recording then if it's okay with everybody, because when the match is over, because with 5 points, he still wins.
Yeah.
We'll have to see then.
We'll have to see how it goes.
Yeah, sure.
Let's hope they won't go into thinking mode. The funny thing is that he can actually play the agenda, advance it twice, and not use an archer.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. So if he puts that there, he'll be safe. The only problem is he will probably res an archer on RND, because I'm foreseeing another run on RND, even
True. True.
without the inside jump.
Maybe that's what he's thinking. Should I draw a card and try to get an ice that stops runs?
Yeah, no, that's what he does. He takes something from the stack with Project Catalyst.
He wants a cheap ice that blocks runs, I guess, yeah. He needs to show it, doesn't he?
I think he does. Yeah, there you go. Yeah, he revealed it. He revealed it now. Yeah, be in stock and hedge fund. Just go for it. Or that. Yeah, that's also a good move.
Let's see. It's going to be interesting if the runner gets a barrier breaker.
Yeah, but he doesn't.
No. Lots of sinking. I'm guessing he's going to go for a parasite or trust or maybe a data sucker and then try to trust something and get into archives. Crypsis.
Okay.
Okay.
Yeah, but he doesn't have the money for it, so
No,
again, I think he ain't gonna end.
he does have the money. He has the 2 cyber feeders and he can
Oh,
play
yeah.
Crypsis and then run archives. He has the money for it. Damn, it was a good game. It was really interesting to see who is going to win this. I think the corporation had the biggest chance to win.
I'm pretty sure he would have won. Crypsis is just not enough. You can't just do with Crypsis.
He could, if he managed to play Scripsis and hit an agenda, Then he can run
Oh,
here.
definitely, yeah.
It was
You
it
needed
w
one more.
Okay, well, I guess we'll have to end this recording here. And still a good game anyway.
Very nice game.